Hey everyone, this is Mike Andes, and you're listening to episode 148 of the Business Bootcamp Podcast. Today, we are taking a question that came in from the website from Sam about his audio creation business, and we're going to be talking about business versus passion. Now, before we get into today's episode, I want to say a big thank you to today's sponsor, which is FreshBooks. If you haven't already, check out the free trial they're offering everyone that's listening, all the business bootcampers out there. It's FreshBooks.com/bootcamp. And if you go there, you can get 30 days, try it completely free. And if you're right now, you're probably trying to get everything ready for tax season. You know, it's coming up right now. You might already have your appointment with your accountant, or you do it on TurboTax, whatever like that. And the big thing right now is this is when it shows, I think, with small business owners, if they really know their numbers and if they really have been keeping track of all their expenses, income, everything is like lined up. Well, they know their numbers. Like, we've talked about how important it is to know your numbers, but it also is a great way to keep track of it is have a CRM and a online cloud supporting accounting software like FreshBooks. So check it out. If you are scrambling for numbers and you feel like you're kind of like all over the place right now with your taxes, I'd highly recommend FreshBooks.com/bootcamp, and you'll get a free 30-day trial. Test it out. I promise you this time next year, if you're still using FreshBooks, it won't be a mad scramble for taxes. So that's it for today for the sponsor. Now, today's episode comes from a question that came on the website. So if you have a question, go to businessbootcamppodcast.com, and Sam left an audio note. So let's go ahead and play that. But right before we do that, I want to just make sure everyone out there knows that I have started a vlog. So if you haven't already checked it out, it's on YouTube. I have two different channels that are called Mike Andes, but you want to look for the one that has me looking like a landscaper, not like the one that has the logo for the podcast, not the orange one, the other one. And so on that, I put one to two videos every single week, kind of behind the scenes of what I do with my landscaping company. And then that's the focus of it, because I'm promoting landscapebusinesscourse.com. But I also will show stuff like consulting stuff that I do and some podcasting things and all of that. So check it out. Just go Mike Andes Business Bootcamp or Mike Andes Landscape Business Course on YouTube. Subscribe there, and every week you'll get one or two videos behind the scenes. It'll be cool. All right. Today's question is going to roll here in 10 seconds. Here we go. It's from Sam, and he left this question from the Speak Note widget on the website. Here we go.
Hey, Mike. My name is Sam Sharples, and I'm from Birmingham, Alabama. I have a music recording business startup called Audio by Sam, and I did about $1,000 of business last year, which was my first year. I would love to scale the business into something that I can actually live off of full-time, but I have two problems on my mind. The first problem is growing my target audience beyond my friends and their friends. Because my services don't compare to the multi-million dollar studios in the area, because I don't have the same technology, I don't have the same facilities, I don't have the same celebrity clientele, what I do offer is a higher level of dedication to the artist's dreams than these studios can provide. But I don't know how to communicate that to my target audience except by word of mouth. And my second problem is that I don't want to remove myself from producing the music in order to run the business side. I'm in this business for the love of music and not for the love of business, and I don't think I'll have time to wear both hats as the business starts to grow. So thanks so much, Mike, for your time. Let me know your thoughts. My website is audiobysam.com. Thanks.
All right, well, thank you, Sam, for writing in on the podcast, on the website there. And so I'm just looking at your website, audiobysam.com. First of all, I like the fact that you have packaged pricing for your services. So you have like what the cost is for recording a single song, a song for an EP, which is 4 to 6 songs, extended play, then a full-length album, and original compositions. Like, you have those four packages that you can charge people for your services. So I like that. Because most of the time, a young artist is just looking for prices, and it's not easy to find, and so that's good. Now, this is what I really want to talk about today, and that is passion versus business. And so, a lot of people will take their passion and create a business around it, okay? And so that's what you're really doing, Sam, is you've taken the passion that you have for music, and you're like, okay, well, I'm going to become, you know, audiobestbysam.com. I'm going to become, you know, the guy that records music for young artists and can help them promote it. And so this is the thing. People, like, regardless, like hairstylists, they enjoy doing perms or dyeing hair or whatever, and then so they go into hairstyling. And then, you know, the builder likes to work with his hands, or he likes building things or concrete or whatever he likes to do. And then so he becomes a contractor. And so because they're passionate about something, that's what drives the start of their business. And so that's not bad, but the reason a lot of times small businesses fail is because the business is built around their passion instead of the market. And so when you think about a business, if you want to create a business that's profitable, it's going to succeed, that's not going to be just another statistics of small business, if it's actually going to grow, become successful, it's going to become scalable, if it's going to be all that, you've got to ask yourself the question, are you building a business or are you building a hobby and something around your passion? Now, I do not think that the business has to be separate from your passion. I really think the greatest entrepreneurs and the greatest businesses are the ones started out of passion, because it fuels the entrepreneur, the small business owner, to stay up out like crazy hours and to do things that no one else will do because they're passionate about it. Whereas if you're doing something you're not passionate about, you're not going to be as inclined to do things out of the ordinary, spend the weekends, the nights, the evenings, working hard, head down, grinding 100 hours a week. And so, that being said, Sam, you talk about, well, I don't want the business part to take away from the music part, which is your passion. And so, what I would suggest to someone like you, Sam, is this. And this might seem really narrow, and maybe I don't have all, I'd like to, you know, talk to you more about what your particular circumstances are. But this is what I would tell you to do, Sam. I would tell you to create content every single day. And so if you're passionate about it, you're like, great, awesome, I get to record music a lot. That's what I love to do. That's what create music and all this stuff. If I were you, I would create lots and lots of content and make it really good content. And so some people like stress out too much about how good it is, and so like they release one or two songs a year. Then there's the guy who does a mediocre job but produces content every single day, and he'll pop because one or two of the 365 songs he makes every year are really, really good. And so what I would do if I were you, Sam, is focus on honing your skills of music recording and those skills by doing it so frequently and publishing that content. What that is going to do is you're going to eventually begin to get a fan base, whether it be on SoundCloud and other platforms, Musical.ly and things like that, and you're going to start creating this audience. Then what's going to happen is when someone that's been following you, and when they want to create music, they're going to come to you. And you're going to get some of those bigger artists, and you're going to get some of those, and they're going to be paying a whole lot better than what you're charging right now. And so I wouldn't say this, like, this is totally to you, Sam, because, and I hope people out there listening that are passionate about what they're doing, or the skill and the trade that they're engaged in with their business, because this is the thing, if you really are passionate about music, you should be able to do it regardless of the monetary value. And that's okay. Now, what you said, Sam, is what changed my mind on this. Like, if you would have said, I want to grow my business, I want to grow how many artists, and I want to grow how many songs I'm doing, and for more money, and I want to charge more, then I would have been like, we would have been talking about promotion. You know, we would have been talking about getting your name out there and getting certain types of artists and trying to get them, you know, doing free work for them or spec work. I'd be trying to assist or collaborate with other music engineers and artists and doing things that are completely out of the ordinary, trying to hit up these large artists, doing things on the side for them for free, like following them, whatever it is, to give them value. And then you get the subtitle, or you get the ad at the end that says you did the work. Now, that's a different story, because that's very much biz dev. That's advertising, that's cold calling, that's reaching out, that's advertising, marketing, working with other agencies, like that's collaboration, lots of emails, and trying to, you know, meet other people in the industry, a lot of communication, and trying to go to these meetings where you're going to see other people in your industry. That's biz dev. So when you said, I don't want the business aspect to get in the way of my music, that's when I tell people, all right, go full in on the passion and don't worry about the business then. Because if you don't, if business and you don't want to grow your company and you don't want it to jeopardize the music, then go all in on the music. Go like 110%. It's going to take longer. It's going to take longer for you to go full time doing this or make more money. It'll take a few, several years. Instead of if you really go biz dev crazy, you might be able to get there in a couple years. It might take 5 or 10 years if you go really hardcore music, create lots and lots of content, and become a magnet for people to come to you instead of trying to do biz dev and attract other people towards you by, you know, reaching out. So there's two different ways of marketing. One, you're a magnet and people are attracted to you. Number two, you work like grabbing out. You're trying to go get new business. That's biz dev. That's advertising. That's marketing. That's sales. And if that's not what you want to do, Sam, that's not a bad thing. It just means you gotta take a different approach because you're gonna want to eventually get the big names. You're gonna eventually want to get more people wanting you to record their albums and record for them original compositions and all of that. But until that time, you gotta create content and become the expert in your field. And it will take years. This is not an overnight, you know, create 20 songs in the next month and suddenly you pop. That's not what it's about. It's about creating content over a long period of time and getting one or two hits out of the 365. Those ones take off in SoundCloud or Musical.ly or online somewhere. And whether that you're recording for other artists or you're creating that music yourself, every single day, if you did that, I guarantee you that would create an audience. That would create a network of people that are following you. And when they want to create music, because their music, you know, they're enjoying the type of music you're making, they're going to be attracted to the person who created that music. And so if they ever want to create their own music or if they have an artist that they know, they're going to tell them about you. And so that's the long way of going about it. And that's when you let your passion go wild and scale the business part back. Like if you're talking about passion versus business, scale the business part back and go full board on passion and eventually you'll convert. And so really what people got to realize is like you can't do 100% passion and 100% business. It's very difficult. I shouldn't say you can't do it. It's just much more difficult because if you're going 100% business, that means 24/7 you are out there selling, you're out there collaborating, you're out there marketing, shaking hands, giving business cards. But then that's time you can't spend behind an audio track or behind a computer or behind a soundboard mixing and things. And so that's when you've got to figure out, okay, are you going to go passion and go long term? Like just really pour yourself into it. And in doing that, in pouring yourself into your passion, you're going to get better at what you do. Like I really believe that, Sam, if you took an entire year and focused on creating one track every single day, publishing that, you know, on SoundCloud, Musical.ly, like all these different sites, creating Facebook channels, whatever you have, and I see you have YouTube, so like if you create music videos or whatever it is, every single day, one piece of content, I guarantee you that you will get better at your craft, number one, and that in turn, it's gonna become a snowball effect. As you get better, you're gonna attract more people, and the more people, then you're gonna get better. Like, it's gonna be this snowball, and eventually people will start coming to you instead of you having your prices on your website and trying to get people on coming to you and trying to reach out and trying to grab more people. The reason I'm giving this advice, and this is so opposite a lot of times of what the stuff I share on the show, is because it's so anti-business. It's go all in on your passion. And the only reason I would say that is because of what you said, Sam. You said you did not want the business aspect to jeopardize the music aspect. And in this case, I think for you, trying to split 50-50 isn't going to work. It's not going to make you happy, and it's not going to make the business successful. Trying to do a halfway job on the business end and just kind of throwing, you know, talking to your friends or throwing some media post up once in a while, that's not going to do anything. Okay? Then while you're doing that 50% and you're trying to do 50% music, your skills aren't going to get much better. So I would say if you're really passionate about something and you don't want to focus on business, that's fine if you're in it for the long haul And if you're okay with working your other job and making this a side hustle for the next several years, create content every single day, create an audience, and then people will come to you. So regardless of what industry you're in, you're not in music, you might be in some other creative field like painting, you might be in something like building, like contractors. Everyone wants to be the contractor that builds a $10 million house or the mansion, and for these great, amazing, popular stars and, you know, the rich people of the world, and create incredible architecture. That's all fine and great, but where did they get their skills? It's probably been from years of grinding and doing other things. And it was because they're passionate about it, it's because they had hard work. And just because you say, well, you know, I don't feel like I'm making money doing that. Well, is that what, if that's what you're wanting, if you're wanting the money, go biz dev, you go for the sales. You know, spend more time on the sales aspect. Too many people create too much content and don't promote it enough. They create too many good products and don't promote them enough. So if you're going all in on business and you want to make the most money, most bang for your buck, go more on biz dev, go more on marketing, go more on sales, go more on advertising, go more on social media, go more online, all that stuff, okay? Go more promote, okay? But if you're more, I want to create, whether it be music or you're trying to create art or you're trying to create an audience or you're trying to create videos, whatever it is, focus so much on that to where people come to you. Look at all the YouTubers that vlog and things. They started off small. They grew their audience over the course of years, creating content every day, creating videos of them doing whatever, creating this audience. Now, how they make money is marketers and advertisers want them to film their commercials, and they want them to do things around certain projects or ideas or movements, and then they're sponsored essentially, and they are hired to do these incredible projects. And it wasn't them going out and doing a sales page or a sales funnel or creating a mailing list. That's all biz dev. So what you got to focus on is, do you want the money? Go biz dev. There's nothing wrong with that. There's no moral a problem I have with going biz dev and trying to make sales. That's what you got to do to make a living and, you know, pay the bills and grow the business. But the alternative, if you want to make it a side hustle, is to go full board on your passion, make it a long-term interest and a long-term investment, and expect 5 or 10 years down the road, maybe. And you got to be okay with the fact that if it doesn't turn out, if it doesn't become money and nothing pops, that you're okay with it because you're passionate about it. All right, so that's all I'm going to share with you guys today. It's just kind of a different spin, alternative way of looking at things that I don't usually share on the podcast, but I usually talk about this stuff with people who are in the video, music, art kind of industry, or any sort of content creation. So that's it for today. Check out the vlog on YouTube, Mike Andes. You'll see a weekly vlog, sometimes 2 times a week. I'll be sharing kind of behind the scenes, some cool footage. I'll be getting a drone here, so I'll make it interesting. That's it for today. Mike Andes on the Business Bootcamp Podcast, episode 148, signing off.